Welcome to New Possibilities. I speak truth to power without fear. So, Jemele Hill was suspended. ESPN suspended her for 2 weeks for violating their social media policy. They say that this is her second violation. Her first violation was when she called Donald Trump a white supremacist on social media, on Twitter in particular. So she came under fire for making that statement. And now she's put out another tweet, and for this tweet, she was suspended for 2 weeks. And I'm going to read an excerpt from this New York Post article, and then I'm going to provide further commentary. So the article says this. It says, reacting to Dallas Cowboys coach Jerry Jones, who told his players he would bench them if they did not stand for the national anthem, she tweeted, this play always worked. Change happens when advertisers are impacted. If you feel strongly about JJ's statement, boycott his advertisers. Then she went on to further clarify her statement. She said, just so we're clear, I'm not advocating an NFL boycott, but an unfair burden has been put on players in Dallas and Miami with anthem directives. So again, for this, the sister was suspended for 2 weeks. And I just want to talk about this for a few minutes. First of all, I think that ESPN is just wrong, flat out, for deciding to suspend this sister for tweeting her opinions about a very important social justice issue. And that's this issue of players and their right to protest, and also this issue of police brutality. And ESPN should face some kind of consequences for this. I think that people need to stop watching ESPN. And I think that this sister, Jemele Hill, should try to look for other employment. I think that she should try to work with black media, you know, TV1 or some other black media. And I think that this speaks to our need to create our own media. I mean, we have to get to a point where we are in control of our own message, instead of being subjected to other people's propaganda, other people's messages. Instead of us being mouthpieces for other people, let's be our own mouthpieces to project our own message with independence of thought, without being controlled and manipulated and dominated by these other people. I mean, it's a shame that this sister has to tone down her language on social media, you know, has to kowtow and tap dance in order to keep a job. You know, that's horrible. And I don't think that we should tolerate this kind of stuff from ESPN. It's time for us to stop watching ESPN. You know, so that's the first thing. The next thing is this. I think this sister's advice with respect to these advertisers is on the money. You know, I think that those advertisers do need to be targeted. And that's the only thing that these people understand. The only thing that they understand is money. These people have no conscience. They couldn't care less about the plight of African Americans. They couldn't care less about the issue of police brutality. They are all about the bottom line. And if you want to change what these people do, you have to affect their bottom line. And that's one way to affect it. Now, this sister stopped short of calling for a boycott of the NFL, you know, for obvious reasons. I mean, she's already coming under attack for this statement alone. But I think that it's time for us to boycott the NFL. I mean, as I've said in prior videos, because of their treatment of the brother Colin Kaepernick and, you know, how they have persecuted this brother, blackballed that brother, blacklisted that brother, and showed their utter and complete disrespect for the legitimate cause for which that brother was protesting, and that's this cause of police brutality. We have a situation where these pigs, these police, can kill black people and not even brought to trial. In the few cases when they are actually brought to trial, these police walk. So it's time for us to boycott the NFL because they don't have respect for black people. You know, if they did, they would allow these people to protest as they see fit during these games, to simply take a knee. That's one of the most passive, nonviolent forms of protest ever. But they have a problem with that. And I just think that that speaks to the way that they treat these players. They treat these players like rich slaves, where they want to control all kinds of aspects of their lives. These people have no problem with players beating their wives. They have no problem with these players engaged in criminal activity to a certain degree. But when a player wants to speak out against a grave injustice in society, all of a sudden it's a problem. All of a sudden it's an issue. And, a couple of weeks ago, people were criticizing this sister because she retweeted something that this brother, Damon Young, wrote. And, I think that a lot of people were overly emotional and they said she threw black men under the bus and blah, blah, blah. I did a prior video addressing that. I'll include a link to that video and to my first video dealing with this statement that she made on Twitter about Donald Trump being a white supremacist. But I think that those people overreacted, and I think that her commitment to black people is clear. Her commitment to black men is clear. By the mere fact that she's taken a stand, I mean, she's put her career on the line to support these black male players who are the ones protesting against police brutality, who are the primary ones who are taking the knee during these games. So I respect this sister, man. And again, I think that it's time for us to boycott the NFL. And unfortunately, with all this disrespect of Colin Kaepernick, with all this disrespect of black players by the NFL, you still have Negroes, programmed, brainwashed, brain dead Negroes, still supporting the NFL, still watching the games, and still coming up with all kinds of excuses not to boycott the games. I mean, these people remind me of those ignorant people who defied the Montgomery bus boycott. I'm sure there's a couple of fools that defied the Montgomery bus boycott, and they had no problem sitting at the back of the bus like a good little house Negro slave. That's what they remind me of. These people who are critical of those who are actually putting in the work to make a difference in society. You got all these people today that love Martin Luther King now. They love him now that he's dead. But when he was alive, these were the same people player hating on him, criticizing him for protesting. And these same people that pretend to love Brother Malcolm, they were the same people criticizing him, the same people not supporting his movement, the same people that had all this negative stuff to say. I mean, it's a shame that at this point, our people haven't united around this issue of boycotting the NFL. I mean, the NFL would be done. I mean, they would be forced to hire their brother Kaepernick. They would be forced to give players more rights to express their political views if black people said, we're not going to watch any more of these games. We're not going to buy any more of those products. The viewership is already substantially down with these games, and I think that if more black people were united around that cause, it would have even a greater impact. I mean, you already have the brother Jay-Z, I mean, a businessman who probably sacrificed millions of dollars by refusing to play during the Super Bowl. This brother stood with Colin Kaepernick, even as a businessman, somebody who's all about the money and stuff like that. He realized that some things are more important than money. Some things are more important than money. I mean, and this is a tiny sacrifice, not watching a game or not watching ESPN. This is baby stuff. This is light work. And it's time for us to get behind this and support these brothers who are speaking out against police brutality, support the brother Kaepernick, and support this sister, Jemele Hill. So with that, I'm going to say peace and blessings to all of you. Tell me what you think. I'm interested in hearing your opinions. Please rate, comment, and subscribe.